you can't underestimate how 1,000 shows impact us.
And for probably the last 15 years, it's been really loud and really in your face and lights and everything else.
We've always wanted to strip all that back and just walk up to the front of the stage with acoustic guitars and kind of go back to our roots a little bit.
Scared everybody in our business. You know, the agents and managers and all that were like, you're getting bigger and why wouldn't you play the bigger room and all that? And the purpose for me, I think, is what we've seen in the acoustic environments is like when you get rid of all the production, people can really see you a little bit more. And I think with music, you know, making records is not about that. You know, I think people like your music and not you. But when it comes to live shows, I think that the music is really just a tool, you know, for you to sort of express yourself and have a conversation with the audience.
It's tricky because there's nothing to hide behind. Every band you see today, there's an Apple laptop somewhere playing, and that's most of what you're hearing. But we have none of that. And you know, like, I'm about to open my mouth and sing. And for me, singing background vocals, maybe I haven't sang, you know, for the whole first half of the song, and now I've got to sing this high part. So you're just like, please don't squeak, please don't crack.
You just never know what you're going to end up talking about. And some crowds are a little bit more lively, and they're shouting stuff back at you, and you can really hear them. You know, a lot of times the show has gotten bigger over the year. It's, a lot of the personality gets covered up, and I think that there's a lot of talent in the other individuals that I think this sort of atmosphere allows people to see it.
Y'all say hello to my little brother, Bo, over here.
Howdy.
This song that you're about to play, he wrote, this thing that he's playing right now is called a mandola, which is like a mandolin, but longer, deeper, and everything. And he did not have that when he wrote this song. He just tuned a mandolin down really far, and it sounded really crappy on the recording. that he played to us, and we were like, well, we'll definitely change that, you know, before the record comes out. And 6 months later, we're all in love with the sound. We're like, it's genius, you know. And so after Bo got rich and famous, fast forward a couple of years from his modeling career, look at him. But he had this thing made and ended up writing a bunch of our big songs on it. So when you see it tonight, you'll know he wrote a lot of these great songs with that little thing in a closet somewhere. All right, here we go. You ready?
My heart isn't on the feeling that I get from the way you shake your voice.
Experiences are pretty limited, you know, is very real to us, you know, especially early on. We're like, man, I don't know anything about California. I don't know anything about, I've never even been, you know? And so in order for the music to translate to me in the most powerful way, it had to be some human emotion. You know, if there's a difference in relating in a song and trying to teach someone something in a song. And the songs where we're not faking it or trying to be somebody else, those are the ones that relate.
Very early on with songwriting, we had a decision whether to write about topics or write about our life experience. And we felt like people connected most when we were just being honest and vulnerable, putting it all out there and saying, this is what I'm going through, this is how I feel, this is all I can make of it so far.
I hope that you could understand. This is not what I had planned. Please don't worry now. It will turn around. 'Cause I need more time. Just a few moments and we'll be fine. So sing a song. You're all mine. inside. So say you're right, 'cause I know we can make it if we try. And I need more time, just a few more months and we'll be fine.
When people leave shows, they should feel empowered, inspired, you know? And I feel that way at most of the good rock shows I've ever been to, you know? And I think there's just something about that. I think if we went home and we're like, man, the end result was they thought we were cool, or, you know, whatever. I don't know what the other goals for music could be. That never really made sense to us.
Honesty's always been the priority. And so now, in this setting, it's the most honest version of the song being played. There's nothing to hide behind. It's truly just the most raw version, almost like the way the song was conceived.
Anytime you get to look out and see the songs that you are a part of, you see them connect with people, and you see them, especially on this tour, being in that it's acoustic and you can look out and see faces. You know, some of these songs really mean the world to them.
My bones, you found it solid.
Why you wanna bring me this sorrow? 'Cause there's no excuses for what you're doing. There's no excuses for what you're doing. Girl, I've been your lover since high school. Everything I did for you. But if you're gonna tighten this rope around, girl, you better know I'm gonna fight. 'Cause there's no excuses for what you're doing. There's no excuses for what you're doing. For